Today we're going to be making a fun journal page with triple envelope pockets. Hello, it's Barbara. This is an idea I saw on a video by Yvonne, Preston, and I thought it was a really fun addition to a journal. You can find her video linked below in the description box. So let's try to make this. I'm going to be using some coffee dyed paper. Now, as you can see, this one is a bit different than your regular dyed coffee papers. If you want to know how I've done this, I was following a tutorial by Sigita, and I will link my video for this below as well, but just use regular coffee dyed paper. We won't see all that much of it in the end anyway. So I'm going to start off by tearing or cutting the page in the width that I want my envelopes to be. So this is the journal page I want to put them on. So I'm going to make them, of course, a little smaller. So I will just take my ruler, because I think it's easiest just to tear these pages. Then I will fold piece up. Make it a little more, actually. I'm not measuring this. I'm just doing this by eye. That, and then we need a flap to go down, and we need to have a gap between the edge here and the folding down. Otherwise, it will be hard to get something into the envelope. So I'm leaving about maybe half of an inch like this. So this is going to be our envelope shape, and we're just going to glue these two sides down. So I will just make three of these. So I have my three envelope shapes here, and actually, you know, they are kind of wonky. I guess I folded it a bit wonky, but instead of trying to make these perfect, I have decided I want to make them be a little bit wonky, just because I think that's kind of fun. So what I'm going to do to add to that is I'm actually going to tear the edges of my flap just to make it more organic, I guess. But what Yvonne does is she uses a corner rounder, and she just rounds the corners of the flap. So if you want it looking nice and neat, then that is what you could do. Or you could just leave the corners as they are. So they will then be just layered one on top of each other, and the flaps are kind of overlapping each other. That's what Yvonne does, but maybe we don't need to do that. There's enough space for me to actually not, well, I guess I do want them overlapping just a little bit like that. So they will go on my page like this. Yvonne didn't close these at all. But I'm thinking I want mine to close, so this is optional. And one thing you could do to close them is if you have some Velcro dots, you could just close them like this. But I again want to be using my magnets that I recently used, and I got these, as I mentioned before, from Amazon in Germany, and I will link that link for you. I'm sure you can find something similar on the American Amazon. Oops. So they are tiny but strong, like this. So they're really tiny, and they are super strong. And they just attached to my laptop. So I want to attach these. So I want one to always be on the inside of the flap and one to be on the inside of the page here, so that then it will close. And one viewer suggested that, because in the last video I had put some coffee dyed paper over it, and she suggested just put some tape over it, some regular tape, and actually that's a great idea and much easier. So I'm going to attach this with my 3-in-1 glue. I think it's good to use a strong glue for this. So I'm just gonna put a glue dot somewhat in the middle and add my magnet. then I will add some regular tape on top of that. The point of doing that is that when you slide something in your envelope, that it doesn't get caught on the magnet. So we have the magnet here, and now we need, of course, the corresponding magnet. Now, I don't want my magnet to be seen when I open the flap, so I want to actually put it on top here where I will be adding some decorations. So I can feel the magnet where it is, so it's right here. So I'll put another glue dot. And that magnet will anyway jump exactly into the right position. We'll again just add a little bit of tape here, even though we're gonna cover it anyway. Yeah, I don't really know if that's necessary. Yeah, so that's gonna be covered, but now it just closes nicely. And so now we can close this envelope. I'm using some tacky glue, which is in my art glitter glue bottle. Okay, so now I just close the sides. Okay, so that's number one. And I will do the same for the other two envelopes. And it would have been smarter to do this before I glued them up, but I will now ink all of my envelopes with my vintage photo. Don't have to worry about the backside because that will be glued down anyway. While I'm inking up this last envelope, I wanted to quickly address the subject of junk journaling. Maybe you've seen a few videos ago, and if not, I will link that one below for you again. I mentioned that I saw a video from Jenny Belly where she was talking about the definitions of the different terms in journaling and how actually what we are doing here with kind of like what I'm doing and what I think a lot of us are doing is not actually junk journaling because we're not actually using junk. So I've read all of your comments and replies, and thank you so much for these. And I really thought about this a long time because then I didn't know what to call our kind of journaling because it didn't fall into any of the categories that Jenny Belly mentioned. And a lot of you answered saying, why put yourself in a box? Why is it important to call it anything specific? And, you know, just enjoy the process and don't worry about what it's called. And some of you said actually it's still called junk journaling because we do also add junk, and you know, you shouldn't have such a narrow definition. So I've been thinking about this for a few days, and I've been trying to come up with another name that I could call what we're doing. But in my opinion, junk journaling has evolved from what it was a few years ago, and now it's just common to also use digitals and to use ephemera that maybe isn't junk, but you make it look maybe vintage, maybe not. But you add all kinds of things to your journal, and some of it is junk and some of it is not. And I think this term really has evolved from what it used to be, just strictly junk of what you would throw away, to all kinds of beautiful things, but it seems to be the widely used term in the meantime. So I'm gonna go back to calling it junk journaling because I still do think it is the most known term and what we can relate to. So I hope that everyone is okay with that, that I'm just gonna go back to saying junk journaling. Okay, so I have my three envelopes here. We, of course, still need to decorate them. First, we can glue them onto each other. I just have to decide, do I want the flaps kind of layering over each other? Yeah, that does actually look nice, how Yvonne was doing that. So I think I'll do it like this. what she did is she attached them so that she didn't glue the whole thing down, but so that this here would be a pocket as well. So that means she just glued the sides down. So all we're going to do is put a bead of glue on either side here and here, but also on the bottom. I'm not even sure she put a glue on the bottom, but we're doing that. And so I'm gonna glue it so that the flaps just barely overlap, and I'm gonna make sure that they line up on the edges here. And we'll do the same thing for this one here. Okay, one, two, three. So we have lots of pockets there. And when we glue this in, we can either make, I mean, we could either just glue the whole thing down, or we can glue it down so that it has a top-loading pocket or a side-loading pocket. Given that I have more space on top than on the side, I think I will make this into a side-loading pocket. A top-loading pocket. So I'm just gonna glue down the three sides here. You could also sew this in with your sewing machine if you would like. I'm just being lazy. It feels for me like it's been forever since I've done a video, although it's only been like not even a week. But I've been away from Vienna for 2.5 days with my BFF, who was having a training 2 hours away, and I decided to go with her, even though I hardly saw her because she was training all the time and preparing in the evening then for the next day. But it was really, really nice to just be away from the city for those 2.5 days and to just see something else, because of Corona and everything, I haven't been anywhere since 1.5 years. And I just really had the feeling I need a change of scenery. So that really was a medicine for the soul. And I really enjoyed just kind of taking it slower for a few days, going for walks and things like that. So now I think we need to decorate our envelopes a little bit. Since I want to have everything kind of autumn themed still, I want to use some autumnal, as I learned the word. It's not autumny, it's autumnal. I want to use some autumnal elements. So this is a snippet roll that I made using some of my printouts from my shop, these mushrooms. And I've made a similar snippet roll in another video, and I will link that one for you. And also there was recently a video by Joey DeFee where she made some snippet rolls, which are a bit different to what I'm doing. She did a lot of hand painting of some, like, I think she used book pages and she used map pages, and she made everything from scratch. So I will link her video below as well. I think that one might be fun to watch. But anyway, I have this one. And so now I think I'm gonna use this one because these are all too big. I mean, this one would be fine, but maybe I will put this one on the bottom here. But I think this one would work too. Now, let me see if I can make this piece here work. So I'm just gonna tear this. I didn't sew through this one, so that means I can just easily tear it, but you could of course also snip the threads with your scissors. So we want this, or I want this. I kind of want it overlapping, but of course I cannot have it overlapping on the top because then it won't open. So I need to have it, I'm actually gonna tear this edge, re-ink that, and I can have it overlapping from the bottom because that won't matter. So I have this, and of course we want to hide the magnet and decorate the rest of the pocket. And so I was thinking maybe I can add some real lace, because we do also have a piece of lace here. So I have here my lace treasure box. And maybe I want to also consider the page that will be opposite this, because it's not this one. I think I will have it here. So these are the colors that we have on this page. So maybe that helps me better to decide what colors to use. I'm wondering if this gold doily would work. I mean, this has, I mean, the button kind of has a similar color, and the belly of this bird is yellow, although it's a different yellow. But let's see if that might work. Not sure about that. Maybe I need something off-white instead. I keep going back to this piece. I'm gonna be so sad when I don't have any more of this. So that's the same one I used in the snippet roll itself. Let's see if I just cut a strip off. And kind of make it wonky. Too much. There, I think that's better, and it covers. I might still just put a tiny piece of that coffee stained paper over it, because I think you can kind of see it through, unless I move my, yeah, I can also just move this over. So what do you think for the top? Yeah, I will go for that. So I'm gonna use my 3-in-1 glue and glue this down. And I'm deliberately having it hang over the side of the envelope. I'm kind of in the mood to just have things sticking out everywhere and nothing being straight. Yep, and now I put glue there where it's not supposed to be. Because I don't want it glued down to the other piece, of course. I will let that dry so that it won't stick on my other envelope. For this middle one, actually maybe we can use this small piece here. See, it's so handy when you have snippet rolls, because then you have your decoration all set to go. You don't have to start from scratch. So we could just add that like this. Let me see, is this dry enough? Yeah, so when it's closed, we'll have these two like this, and I think that is cute. Let me just see if I want to add maybe some of this same lace, if I have it. Looks like this is the last piece I have of that same lace. Just wanna cut this. And then again, I wanna rough it up a little bit. Want it frayed and just looking old. Like that. And now I will just put that underneath so that it just peeks out a little bit. And again, I have to be careful not to have this going over the flap. This one I think is delicate enough that I can just use my tacky glue. And I want it to go over my magnet again as well. Okay, so that's two. Oh, fun. Loving this. And we need something here now. And of course, we need something on the bottom as well. I will see if I can add this one. I'm not sure. It might be too big. No, I think it's okay. I just need to cover this magnet because I don't want this too much in the middle. I would have, well, actually, why not? We could just put it like that. Yeah, I'll just do that. Just put it on. And I think it has enough lace on it that I don't need to add lace underneath, because I think it would be a bit too much then. Again, making sure that I'm just putting the glue on the top and not the bottom where I don't want it glued. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Really cute. Now, what do we put here? I mean, we don't theoretically have to put anything here because we have a lot of decorations going on. So let me think what to do here. I'm thinking maybe a sentiment would be nice down here. So I'm bringing in my cigar box where I have some of my sentiments. This is a mixture of travel sentiments, crafting sentiments, all kinds of things. And I think I want some of my nature sentiments from my shop. And I think there's a few which would be really nice here. For example, Lost in the Beauty of Nature. That one would work really well. This is an opportunity to use some of my longer sentiments. I really like this one. Do not feel lonely. The entire universe is inside you. I really like this one. And it actually fits perfectly. Okay, I'll keep that one in mind. And I'm one with the earth. I really love this one too. That one actually works really well, especially with the mushrooms and the colors. So I don't need to look further. Actually, this one is speaking to me the most. So I will use that, and it's definitely too white for me. So I'm going to use my tea dye and my blending brush. Both I have linked below if you need it. But of course, if you print these on coffee dyed paper, then you don't have to worry about inking it up afterwards. And that's better. I do want some more texture underneath, but I don't want to add more lace because I just think that would be overkill. So I'm just going to use another part of my coffee dyed paper that has like these dark stains and put that underneath by just tearing it. And I'm just actually remembering, if you don't want to make these yourself, I do also have these in my shop. You can check the, I have a set of coffee dyed papers and you will find this kind. You can just print them out and don't have to do it yourself, but it is fun to do yourself. So check out the video on how to do that. It is super, super easy. I will ink up these edges that don't have the dark color. Now I still need something for this large pocket on top here, and I thought it would be fun to make a tag to go in there, like a large tag. And I recently came across these napkins at a local shop, so I thought this would actually work perfectly with this page here. And let's make a quick tag using a napkin. I will first remove the layers because I only want the top layer. So I'm going to take my tape, plop it on there, and it will just tear the napkin so I can easily take the layer off. Napkins usually have 3 layers, not always. This doesn't seem see-through enough, I think. I'm actually not sure now. This could only be 2 layers. Let me try it on the piece that I don't want to use. Okay, yeah, there is another layer. Because I've also seen napkins that only have 2 layers. So I was a bit skeptical. And also because the print is on this one as well. So yeah, so it's always good to test it on a part maybe that you don't want to use. All right, so we have that. I will just cut widely around this because I know I won't be using the whole thing. It's just easier to work with. And I want to add it onto some book pages. So this is from a vintage German book. book page with some beautiful script, which will show through the tag. And I want to double it up, although this page is quite thick. I do want to double it up, so I will glue these two pages together with my glue stick. And I don't even have to worry about going all the way to the edge exactly, because we will be cutting it out anyway. So now we can add our mushroom onto the text part. And again, I'm going to be using my glue stick for this because I don't like the mess of decoupaging with Mod Podge or gel medium or whatever it is that this is usually done with. I just like drier mediums because I really don't like the mess and then having to deal with cleaning the brushes and I get it all over. So this is just much easier. And I do also like the texture of the napkin, which is kind of like a fabric texture. So I'm just going to put this on and gently from the middle outwards, I'm going to just burnish this with my fingers. Also, when I do the decoupage technique, I end up tearing the napkin somewhere. So I'm just not very good at it. So this is just so much easier. There, that's all it takes. We of course have to make sure that it fits into our pocket. So I want to mark the width that I can make this. I have to take into consideration that the glue, of course, seeps in a little bit. It's gonna be very close for my for my mushrooms to still be on there. I want it to slip in and out easily. I think this will work. I'm going to use just my ruler. I don't want to use my trimmer, my paper trimmer, because I think it might tear the napkin. So I don't want to risk that. So I'm just going to cut this with my scissors. But I do want straight edges. Yeah, that works just fine. So now, of course, we also have to adjust the height. And on the top, well, first of all, I think I have to cut it a little bit. And then I also want to cut the corners to make like a tag shape. I'll just flip that to the other side to make the corners equal. Okay, so here's our tag shape. Let's see if it fits in nicely. We could actually cut it a little bit shorter because I do want to add a topper. Yeah, I think I'll make it just a bit shorter on the bottom. And this one I actually do want to sew around just to give it another texture and interest. Now, if you don't have a sewing machine or you don't want to sew, you could also do some faux stitching with maybe a marker or fine liner and then just draw like a stitched pattern all along the edge. But I'm actually going to take this to my sewing machine. This is what it looks like once it is stitched. I just used a black thread in a straight stitch. I have inked up the edges, and this kind of seems a little bit too white to me, so I'm again going to take my tea dye and go over that a little bit. I don't know how much the camera is picking up, but that has definitely lost its white luminosity. If you want to just have it as a decorative tag, this is all you need to do, but I want to actually journal on the back. So I want to add some coffee dyed paper to journal on, and I'm just going to use the same paper that I used for the envelopes and just trace my tag. Obviously, if you want to see the stitching on the back side too, then you do this before you stitch around it. And one more tip, if you do sew around your tag and you use the napkin technique, please be sure that your glue media, whatever it is dry, completely dry before you sew, because otherwise you might completely ruin your sewing needle. I know it's hard to be patient. But the glue stick, for example, dries really fast. For larger surfaces, I just really like using the glue stick because it's not so wet, it's not so messy, and also because it doesn't squish out on the sides when I put it on the other piece. In lack of a bone folder on my desk, just gonna use my ruler to flatten this. See, if I do this with wet glue, the glue would come out on all of the sides. I always work from the middle out. Now I have to adjust it, because of course tracing something will never make it exactly the same size as the other piece. Plus I put it on wonky, so but nothing that can't be fixed. Now I just ink it up. I want to of course also put a topper on the tag, because it would be fun to have something peeking out here. I guess lace would make sense, or yeah, actually, lace would make sense because we have lace here everywhere. I'm just gonna go with the same lace that I used here. I'll just snip off a piece. And I think it also needs a sentiment here because it kind of looks bare. So let's see what my treasure box has in store. This would need something a bit smaller. Breathe and calm. Actually, those work really well for me because of what I want to journal on the back about. So what do I want? The calm or the breathe? I think, although the calm, I think works better because it's a bit bigger, the font is bigger. I do like the breathe because it just goes better with what I wanna write. Again, I'm going to go over this with my tea dye. And I also want to give it some sort of a background to make it stand out more. So I'm thinking let's just use this paper again. So now I can journal, and I want to journal about my trip that I just had. How important that was for my soul, and how I was able to then just breathe and just feel all the stress disappear. So this is now going into the pocket. There is a lot of lace going on, yes. While I was just writing about this trip, I remembered it was so weird because when we got there on Sunday afternoon, and we were the only people in the whole hotel because of course COVID, and it was really weird. Like, we had to ring the doorbell to be let in, and they made, yeah, there was no food because the kitchen was closed. and of course they didn't open it just for two people. So we went to the next bigger town, which was still tiny because we were like in the middle of nowhere. And it was like 7 at night by the time we went out. And thankfully we found one open place, like which had like Turkish food, which was fine. It was definitely a new experience coming from a bigger city. And yeah, then the next 2 days, my BFF had her training in the hotel. And so there were more people. So that kind of felt better. There were 8 people that came for the training then the next day. But that first evening was kind of strange. So I do still need something to put in these pockets, right? I still have a lot of misprints from when I was designing my products for my shop. So I want to use some of them because I definitely don't want to throw them away. And I think these colors work really well. And I don't want to add more mushrooms because I just think that's mushroom overload. We have enough here now. So I wanted to add something else that fits nicely with the colors. And I think these would work well. This is a misprint of my grungy journaling cards. And since I don't want them to be flimsy, I'm going to back them with some more of the same book page that I used for the tag. So I will cut these out and glue these on here. I don't mind that on one of my tags, my script is going vertically, and on the other ones, it would go horizontally. I don't care. Before I ink these up, I will round the corners with my small corner rounder. I will link one of these for you below as well. This is what they look like now with the rounded corners and the inked up edges, book pages in the back. And now we just add them to our pockets. I did cut them down a little bit because I wanted to make sure they would fit in the envelopes nicely. I will leave them sticking out a little bit to make it easier to take them out. Perfect. How fun is this pocket? So thank you, Yvonne, if you ever watch my video. Probably not, but if you ever do, thank you for showing us this fun interactive element for our journal pages. I think it fits so well with everything else that we have been doing. I will again link my junk journal with me's, the playlist for you below in case you've missed any of these, because there's so many fun interactive ideas. This is getting quite bulky. Thank you so much for hanging out with me as always. Love you guys.